Well, AI is part of Saudi Arabia's Vision 2030 strategy, which aims to identify new revenue sources as the Gulf state diversifies away from fossil fuels. Its goal is to become a top 15 country in AI by spending the rest of this decade adopting the technology at home and then exporting it from 2030. Joining us now to expand further on the kingdom's plans is Majid AlShehry, spokesperson for the Saudi Data and AI Authority, also known as SADAIA. Good morning to you, Majid. Really good to have you on our show today. Look, I'm just going to start off with a question that I think many viewers also would love to get an answer to, which is exactly what are Saudi Arabia's AI ambitions? What do they encapsulate?
Morning, Jumana. Saudi Arabia is positioning itself as a global leader in AI, and we are leveraging the strategic vision for the country, Vision 2030, to build a complete ecosystem of regulatory framework, economical support system, and achieving what we can do to unlock the potential of the data sets that we have in the government, in the country, to build a better future for the humanity in the kingdom. And we are demonstrating that by working globally with our partners, whether NGOs, companies, other governments, to achieve really interesting things that we are very proud of so far since the launch of SADAIA in 2019.
Yeah. And is this mostly about the rollout of AI applications that will help improve the quality and efficiency of people's lives? Or is it about spending in the infrastructure around AI, things like data centers or even potentially foraying into chip making?
So as SADAIA, we are having a mandate to build the whole ecosystem of that. So it doesn't mean that we'll do it by ourselves. We are partnering with companies to do many of these things. So if you notice, in the past couple of years, we had few big announcements by hybrid scalers or hyperscalers like Microsoft, Google, even Amazon and Oracle. All of them have been already started to build those huge computing and data centers in the kingdom by themselves or maybe through partners in the kingdom. And that's something we really appreciate and we support and encourage. Now, when it comes to the models, we have started our own and we have built ALAM, our Arabic large language model, and that's a response from SADAIA, Saudi Arabia, to the movement globally happening right now in advanced countries in AI, including United States, Europe, China. And we have introduced ALAM. ALAM is an Arabic large language model, and it's really advanced in the Arabic language. That's what we focus on. We are producing the culture of Saudi Arabia, the understanding and the principles and the values of what we believe in Saudi Arabia in our large language model. We have a very rich expertise. We have a very large content in Arabic. Some of them were actually not digitalized. We have digitalized that knowledge to introduce it to the rest of the world as a knowledge worth to be included and embedded in our large language model.
Yeah, really interesting. And one thing I do want to ask you is we reported back in November that Saudi Arabia is working on an AI project called Project Transcendence and that would have as much of a $100 billion backing. Can you tell us more about that project and how it fits and aligns with SADAIA's ambitions?
So I'm not going to comment on certain projects, especially if we are not the owner of that project. Probably you can check with the entity that announced that project to get the details. However, I can assure you that in 2020, we have released our national data and AI strategy. And within that strategy, we have identified certain KPIs by the year 2030. Since then, we have been working very hard to announce a few projects in infrastructure and investments and training and building talents and capabilities and other aspects that are important, very important from our strategy. And we believe that we have already the good environment that will allow, especially from the regulatory frameworks, we have secured our environment by releasing the personal data protection law to protect the privacy of our people. Also, we have introduced a lot of policies, including the anti-cybercrime law and the freedom of information policies, a very good set of policies. And those sets will definitely support companies that are interested to invest, interested to come into the market, and also introduce their own solutions and innovations.
Yeah, I want to pick up on what you were saying about the Arabic language model, Al-Alam, and also just tie it into what we discovered about DeepSeek about a month ago, and the fact that alternative language models, large language models, can be brought to the market at substantially lower costs. How much of a pivotal moment do you think this was for the world of AI and for the world's understanding of how much it's going to cost to train up some of these models in the future?
Yeah, so we in Saudi Arabia remains committed to advancing the AI development in general, regardless of the external constraints. We believe that having access to GPUs is really valuable, and we are progressing to less dependence on the hardware. We believe with time, our AI engineers, not just in Saudi Arabia, but globally, will be able to utilize the less expensive GPUs to produce something out useful for the humanity. And that's really happening with the models. It started with DeepSeek, but even in the US, the good GPUs now started to optimize their training and the cost of the models. And that's really positive, in my opinion, for the ecosystem and the development of the new and future AI models.